We're asked to find the possibilities that for 7 to the A plus 7 to the B plus 7 to the C plus 7 to the D ends in two zeros. In other words, has remained a zero when divided by 100. And A, B, C, and D have to be single digits. So it's a good idea to look at the possibilities for the remainder of just one of these terms, for example, 7 to the A, when it is divided by 100. So A could be 0. 7 to the 0 is 1, which has remainder 1 when divided by 100. 7 to the 1 is 7, which has remainder 7. 7 squared is 49, which has remainder 49. And 7 cubed is 343, which has remainder 43 when divided by 100. Now, when we look at the next power of 7, 7 to the 4, that equals 2,401. And so it also has remainder 1. And since the last two digits of 7 to the 4 are 0, 1, if I multiply any power of 7 by 7 to the power of 4, I won't change the last two digits. So also, 7 to the 8 has last two digits 0, 1, and so has remainder 1. Also with remainder 7 are 7 to the 5 and 7 to the 9. Seven to the 6 also has remainder 49. And 7 to the 7 also has remainder 43 when divided by 100. So putting all this together, there are only four possible remainders for a power of 7 when divided by 100. 1, 7, 49, and 43. And for remainder 1 or remainder 7, I have three choices for the single-digit exponent. And for remainder 49 or 43, I have two choices for the exponent. Remember that. We will use it later. So now let's focus just on the remainders of the four powers of 7. Let's call these remainders P, Q, R, and S. And they must all be either 1, 7, 43, or 49. And their sum must be a multiple of 100. Now, the smallest that each of P, Q, R, and S can be is 1. So their sum must be at least 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 4. And similarly, the largest each of P, Q, R, and S can be is 49. So their sum is no more than 4 times 49, which is 196. And there is only one multiple of 100 between 4 and 196. So in fact, P plus Q plus R plus S must equal 100. So now we know that the sum of P, Q, R, and S must be exactly 100. We can use some slightly more sophisticated size arguments to further constrain the possibilities for P, Q, R, and S. You'll see that two of the possibilities are small, and two of the possibilities are large. So let's use that to our favor. So suppose we had three or more of P, Q, R, and S being large, i.e. being 43 or bigger. So if more than two of P, Q, R, and S are large, greater than or equal to 43, then the smallest that P plus Q plus R plus S could possibly be is we have at least three that are at least 43. And the final one must be at least one. It must be at least that sum, which is 130. And if it's at least 130, it cannot equal 100. So what if more than 2 of P, Q, R, and S were less than or equal to 7? Now we look at what the largest possible value of P plus Q plus R plus S can be. At least 3 of them are less than or equal to 7. And the last one is definitely less than or equal to 49. And so the sum is less than or equal to that sum, which is 70. And if the sum is less than or equal to 70, it certainly can't equal 100. So that cannot be the case either. So we cannot have more than 2 large numbers, and we also cannot have more than 2 small numbers, 1 or 7. So we must have exactly 2 of P, Q, R, and S being 1 or 7, and exactly 2 of P, Q, R, and S being 43 or 49. So 2 of P, Q, R, and S must be 1 or 7, and the other two must be 43 or 49. The two that are 1 or 7, their possible sums are only 2, 8, and 14. And similarly, the two that are 43 or 49, their possible sums are only 86, 92, and 98. And from here, we can clearly see the only way to have 4 of these numbers adding up to 100, we can either take 2 and 98, giving this solution, or we could take 8 and 92, giving this solution, or we could take 14 and 86, giving this solution. So we have now found all the possibilities for the remainders P, Q, R, and S. They must be one of these three sums. But of course, P, Q, R, and S could go in any order, and furthermore, just knowing the remainder, there are different powers of 7 that have that remainder. So we have to count up the total number of solutions now to get the total number of solutions for A, B, C, and D. So let's consider P, Q, R, and S being these four numbers. How many orders could those four numbers go in? We have to choose from the four places which two places the ones go, and then that forces where the 49s go. So the number of possible orderings is 4 choose 2, which is 6. Similarly, the number of possible orderings of P, Q, R, and S being these four numbers is 6 again, for the same reason. The number of possible orderings for P, Q, R, and S being these four numbers is larger because the numbers are all distinct. They can go in any order, so the number of orders is 4 factorial, which is 24. Each solution for P, Q, R, and S corresponds to multiple solutions for A, B, C, and D, because, as you remember from the beginning, there are multiple powers of 7 that have each of these remainders. There are 3 powers of 7 that have remainder 1, 3 that have remainder 7, and 2 that have remainder 43, 2 that have remainder 49. So for each possibility for P, Q, R, and S, there are 3 times 3 times 2 times 2 ways to choose A, B, C, and D. So the total number of possibilities for A, B, C, and D is the total number of solutions for P, Q, R, and S multiplied by 3, 3, 2, and 2. And this gives the final answer of 1,296 solutions.